Morning students, the topic is selection sort. So it is again one of the types of sorting algorithms. So in selection sort, how we are performing the sorting operation means the first element in the list is selected and the first element is compared repeatedly with all the remaining elements in the list. If any element is smaller than the selected element, then you have to do the swapping operation. Once you finish with the first element, you have to select the element at second position. Again, the second position element is compared with remaining all elements in the list. If any element is smaller than the selected element, then you have to do the swapping operation. Once the second position element is completed, you have to repeat the same process for third position element. This procedure is repeated till the entire list is sorted. So the algorithm for selection sort is, first we have to select the first element of the list. Then you have to compare the selected element with all the other element in the list. For every comparison, if any element is smaller than the selected element, then you have to do swapping. So you have to repeat the same procedure for next position till the entire list is sorted. We will see with one example. Consider we have an array. It consisting of elements 20, 12, 10, 15, 2. So here, the first element is 20. It is selected. It is compared with all the remaining elements in the array. When comparing, if the element is less than the selected element, if the array element is less than the selected element, then you have to do swapping. So 20 is selected and we are searching with the value 12. Since they are not in order, we are swapping them. So again, the element at first position, that is 12, it is compared with 10. Again, they are not in order, so we are swapping. Again, the first element 10 is compared with the next element 15. They are in order, no need of swapping. Finally, the first element is compared with the last element 2. They are not in order, so you have to do swapping. So after the first iteration, the array becomes 2, 20, 12, 15, 10. So in the second pass, you have to take out the second element. So the second element is selected. It is 20. It is compared with the third element. If they are not in order, you have to swap. After swapping, again the element at second position is compared with the next element, that is 12 and 15, they are in order. So again, the element at second position is compared with the last element of the array, it is 10. Since they are not in order, we are performing swap. So it is the end of second iteration. Now the array becomes 2, 10, 20, 15, 12. Like that, you have to repeat the steps until the entire list is sorted. So it is another one example. See, the array contains the elements 14, 33, 27, 10, 35, 19, 42, 44. Okay. So what is my first element? 14. So it is selected. It is compared with all the remaining elements. If the element is smaller than the selected element, then you have to do swapping. Okay. So which one is smaller element? 10 is the smaller element. So you have to swap 10 by 14. Okay. So now the first iteration gets completed. In the second iteration, the second element is selected. That is 33 is selected. And 33 is compared with all the remaining elements. If the element is smaller than the selected element, then you have to do swapping operation. So from searching, you know that 14 is less than 33. So we are performing swapping. The swapping is performed. After the second iteration, 10 and 14 are settled in their correct position. So like that, you have to repeat the entire process until the list becomes sorted. So again, this algorithm is also not suitable for large data set because its average and worst complexity are in the order of n square. Okay, the worst case complexity is order of n square. So that's why we cannot use this algorithm for large data sets. We are going to see the algorithm for the sorting. First, we have to set the min value to location 0 and you have to search the minimum element in the list and you have to swap with the value at location min. You can increment min to point to the next element. Again, the same steps are repeated until the list is sorted. Okay. So with this, we are concluding the selection sort algorithm. Okay. Thank you all.